discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, as mentioned earlier, the item on the agenda this evening is an amendment to the Town of Chalkawinity zoning ordinance under the R3 zoning district, which is section 6.03. Also under item C, conditional uses, the proposal is adding an item 7 regarding the solar farm with reference to the entire solar farm ordinance attached under that item 7. So basically, adding a mechanism to the ordinance to provide for solar farm activity.
Do we have a motion?
To get it on the table, open for discussions. I'd like to make a motion to do that, just open for discussion.
Okay, we'll have a second.
Second.
Okay, now we'll discuss.
Okay.
When I first heard of this, which was back probably 6-7 months ago, farming the land, now good friends. I live right behind where proposed solar farm put it down. Was asking today. And he alerted me to this. And from there, then I made some inquiries and found out its possibility. Well, my first impression was no, absolutely not. Not in the R3 area. I have no problems, I think, renewable energies, solar, wind is a viable mixture that we need to have in this country. We don't need to keep relying on oil and gas. But after a while, we may not see it, but after a while, the bucket's gonna get in. I went to as far as, with the help of Joy, and sent a letter by email to the Attorney General of Cooper. When it was in the legal notices in the paper, said anybody had any qualms about it, let him know. If not, then it would go through, and you might tell me if I'm wrong, that Utilities Commission would not have to hear anything. Is that correct? Or was it, there been some people that were against it? And they would have to have a special hearing. Or would be through the Utilities Commission or whatever. Anyway. And know that that is in place at this point in time. Because once you send one, then they have to go by what the law says and they have to have a hearing. Since then, I've done a lot of work. Acquired a lot, I found out a lot I didn't know about solar farms. To answer some questions about other towns, the mayor and I have sat down via telephone along with Kevin and talked with representatives from Mount Airy and from Fairmont. Neither town had any detrimental things to say about this. I asked them, well, what about the residential area? How close is it in that residential area? And Mount Airy said, well, it's about 1,000 feet from the closest residential, which is about what it would be from my house. I said, how does that affect the building?
Correct me if I'm wrong, Jim.
Says, well, right across the street from the fellow is getting ready to complete his $350,000 home. said, think back. No gun shooting, no wife and husband fighting, no traffic in and out. At nighttime, it's dark, you don't see anything. He said, they're pretty good neighbors. Pretty good neighbors. He said, I wish we had several farms within the city limits. Which took me back, surprised me too. I didn't realize it was that kind out here. And I asked him about the barrier. He said, well, we don't require any. So they keep it clean enough. Which they use sheep. We already have an ordinance in our town that you cannot have sheep. Domesticated animals are the things you have within the city limits. So the animals of whomever, wherever is mute. That's not what happened. A good part of a solar farm, or what my opinion is, the location, location, location. R3 is a limited area, I understand. Or residential. Your R1 has a lot more open areas, which is a low density residential area. And someone had mentioned talking about the conditional uses. Well, if you go through all the zones that you're going to see a conditional use, anywhere from 1 or 2 to 5 or 6 and more of conditional uses in each area. That's just the way it is, and that's the way it allows in some of our state law. That you can basically build a police department or a group of about anywhere you want to, is that right?
As long as the zoning allows.
Well, I mean, these are already the listed conditional use, most of them. The property in question said I was strictly against to begin with. The draw that you saw up there with the footage, I asked them to curve it back. I had to come where the field would jump back out to Bragdaw Lane and then cut from there across to the woodlands going toward the bypass. And those they had laid out kind of a pyramid to a point and then went out like this. I said, well, just utilize the whole back field and not have it coming up any closer to the houses. And therefore, you'll have more acres. Which they did. And then we talked about the buffer zone, in which this is incorporated in our ordinance, except for one that I would like to see change on page 4 under sub B, saying that the vegetative buffer should be placed within 50 feet inside the fence. Well, I would like to see the buffer zone outside the fence. That way, if you look out through there, you're not going to see, and this is anywhere, a chain link fence. You will see the trees and not see the fence. There's nothing, I don't think, of anything of value except for the copper wire out there to be stolen. Anytime you see a chain link fence and nobody's around, then that gives those who like to work at night the opportunity. Yeah. I don't think they want to grab a hold of this copper at nighttime out the boat just to get the look over. I see a lot of positive, Chaka, when it in this, and not just the money. The money aspect is good. The money aspect means the more that the town can get into coffers, the less that our taxes and our services will have to be increased to our constituents. I look one at where it is, which each individual case and each individual area will come before the board. In this case, we're being backing up, and I may not be supposed to be talking exactly about this. But what is proposed, and I guess it was opened up during the public hearing, that it's not going to be safe. I wouldn't even consider having one anywhere if it looked like it was down in back. It's absolutely atrocious. I would not want to live not around in it or close to it, but that's the county's fault. They didn't have the means in place to protect themselves like the town is doing here. I think after you see the trees, because the trees got to be at least 4 foot high within a year or so, I don't think you will ever see a solar farm, whether these fellows build it or whoever else builds it, at any location. Not just at this location, but if it's decided at a different location, that these same orders are required at all solar farms.
Sell this lot of land except as one piece, then it's going to sit there and benefit nothing. If we can have this ordinance put in place, we will have control of what can be there and what cannot be there. And I think that would be to our advantage. And it's not that we're going to decide tonight that that's, it's going to be done. It's, this is just to get this ordinance to where we can have control, better control.
I just have a question. Is the gentleman, is he older and how's his health? Is he going to be around a long time?
We can answer those questions tonight. John's mind's clear?
I've got a question. Of those that have spoke, how many is on Jones Circle and Braggall Lane? Of that, what were the positives and what were the negatives? The HBA names. Jeff was negative, Parker was negative.
I'm negative.
Negative.
I have no problem with the farm at all. In fact, I think it looks quite good. My whole objection is it's in the wrong place. I think it's short-sighted to give over residential land for this kind of purpose. That's my sole objection. In fact, as my next door neighbor, Billy says, to be a nice, quiet neighbor. That's not the issue. I think it's not in the best interest of this town going forward to give up this land for that purpose.
Always in favor to approve it.
Take a question.
Have a motion to approve it.
Before I make a motion, that's what I will say. I've been put on this board to serve people in Chapel Lane. And the impact areas will be Jones Circle and Braggall Lane. I've had several in Jones Circle said it was fine, but the majority of what I see here tonight with my neighbors, that they do not wish to have that in the area. And even though I think it will do the town some fair goodness, I'm not going to entertain a motion. I made the motion for discussion, but I'm not going to entertain a motion on the ordinance or in the R3 area.
Okay. Anybody else? Okay. Let's dive in for the block of motion then. Kevin?
Yes, sir.